What's up, guys? My name is Tai Zen. Welcome to the cryptocurrency.market channel. This is a trading, investing, and entrepreneurship channel where we share with you guys the real world techniques, strategies, and methods that we use to manage a 7, 8, and 9-figure portfolios, okay, in the cryptocurrency market. In this video, guys, I'm broadcasting from District 7 in the beautiful city of Ho Chi Minh City, located in southern Vietnam in the Southeast Asia, okay? In this video, guys, I want to talk about why is it so difficult for people to take action when they need to in crypto land. Like, why is it so hard to buy when the markets are falling, and why is it so hard to sell when the market's running up in a bull market? Like, when Bitcoin was going up to $20,000, why is it so hard to sell? And then now that Bitcoin is falling and all the coins are falling, you know, 70, 80, 90%, why is it so hard to buy, okay? And the easiest way that I can explain this, guys, because for a long time, I did not know why I was, you know, when I was trading stocks, futures, Forex before, I didn't know why it was so hard for me to do it, okay? Even though I did it, right, in the beginning it was hard to do it, and I learned and I did it enough times, you know, because when I was trading stocks and Forex, I was making way more trades. Like, I think at my peak, I was making like over 3,000 trades a year in the Forex market, okay? So because of that, you know, I had a lot of repetition so that I can practice buying and selling. However, that doesn't make it emotionally easy. Like, mentally inside, it was still emotionally really hard to click the buy button or to click the sell button when I needed to, okay? At the time that I needed to, okay? It's always easy to click the buy and sell buttons at the wrong time, but it's not easy to click the buy and sell buttons when you know that it's time. When you yourself know that, hey, I need to sell now, that's when it's hard, okay? Or when I need to buy now, that's when it's hard, all right? So here's the reason why, guys. If you look at the amount of people that's in this world, right? We have like over, I think like the last time I checked, 7.5 billion people on the planet, okay? So if you look at 7.5 billion people on this planet and you ask, how many of those 7.5 billion people know how to make a $1 decision? I'm sure that it's safe to say that probably close to 7.5 billion or 7 billion people know how to make a $1 decision, and they have transacted in $1 before. Maybe there's some poor places where they haven't, where it takes them a few days or maybe a week to transact a dollar worth of transactions, you know. But I would say that it's safe to say that most people in this world have experience in making a decision to transact a $1 decision or a $1 transaction, okay? So it's very safe. But now if we ask ourselves, like, how many people have made a $10 decision or a $10 transaction, right? All of a sudden, you have this big old 7 billion something people that have made a $1 decision or transaction, and now it gets smaller, right? The number of people that can make a $10 transaction or decision is even smaller. And then whenever you ask people, like, hey, how many have made a $100 transaction or know how to make a $100 decision or a $100 transaction, then that number gets even smaller, right? And if you go to like $10,000, that's even smaller, and then $100,000, it's even smaller. And don't even talk about $1 million, because that's only a handful of people in the world know how to make a $1 million decision and know how to take have had experience you know, transacting in $1 million and that you can trust that can do it when it's time to do it, okay? For the most of the planet, most people cannot do that, okay? When it starts to get past like $10,000, the number gets smaller and smaller and smaller. Because if you think about it, let's say that when I was living in the US, right, how many $100,000 decisions did I have to make outside of trading? One, that's it. I bought my house for like $220,000. That was it. That was the only transaction that I ever made in my life outside of trading that involved more than $100,000. And how much did I, and that was, Almost 49 years. In almost 49 years, I made one transaction outside of trading and investing that involved a $100,000 transaction, okay? And then just recently, just about a month or two ago, right, I sold my house for $345,000, right? So I made a second transaction. So I think like next week on Christmas, I'll be 49 years old, right? So in 49 years of my life, when I turn 49 on Christmas, I'm gonna be 49 years old, and in my entire life, I've only made two financial transactions that was more than $100,000. And that was buying my house and selling my house, okay? Outside of trading and investing. Now, if you count inside trading and investing, I've made $100,000 decisions and transactions many, many times, okay? More times than I can remember, okay? But outside of trading and investing, I've only done it twice, buying and selling a house, okay? And if you go below $100,000, how many times have I made a transaction below that that involved, like, let's say $10,000? If I sat down, you know, for about an hour, 2 hours, I'm sure that I can remember every transaction I ever made in my life that involved $10,000, okay? And the reason why I know I can do that is because I didn't do it too many times, right? Outside of buying my car, I bought, I think, like three cars in my life that have been over $10,000. But really, it's not $10,000 because I never made a $10,000 transaction right then and there. I always financed it. So even though I say that the cars that I bought were over $10,000, it's not 100% true, because I would put like a $2,000 down payment, or I would always have good credit. So sometimes I would buy the cars with no money down, and I would just make monthly payments on it, okay, with 0% interest. So because of that, it's safe to say that outside of my house, when I took my, there's a few sales training, a few trading, several, many, many trading courses that I've enrolled in and purchased and studied, right? You know, personal development courses and business courses and trading courses and sales and marketing courses. And all of there was many of them that were over $10,000, but I did not pay $10,000 at one time. I would pay like in installment plans, okay, in different payment plans, like $1,000, $2,000 at a time. Or I would borrow, like me and my friends would pitch in together, and we put a $5,000 down payment, and after that, I would make $1,000 or $2,000 payments each time. But as far as making a $10,000 financial transaction at one time, I don't remember. Oh, you know what? I bought several Rolexes for several of my friends, and those were all over $10,000. And some of those were over $20,000. Those, yes, but that didn't happen until I retired, okay? That didn't happen until I retired. I'm talking about like before I retired from, thanks to crypto. I don't recall making any transactions where I had to pay $10,000 cash all at one time. If I did have to pay for something that was $10,000, it was usually in payments, okay? So because of that, most human beings don't have a lot of experience in making a $10,000 decision, a $100,000 decision, and a $1 million decision. And most people don't have enough practice doing it, and most people don't have enough experience doing it. You know, so it comes from not having enough practice, okay? So what happens is, when it's time for you, like you might be bebopping along, right? And we have several students who got into crypto with a $10,000, $20,000, $50,000 account, and then it turned into several $1 million, okay? So just think about that. In 6 months, in 1 year, in 2 years, in 3 years, all of a sudden, you took a $10,000, $20,000 account, and it turned into several $100,000 or several $1 million. What do you think is gonna happen? You think that you're just gonna run out there and start selling and be good at selling? No, that's not the reality, guys. That's like me asking you to throw you in the ring with a Conor McGregor or a Mike Tyson or an Adesanya, okay? One of these, professional world-class fighters, and expect you to kick their ass. It's not gonna happen. And I would never ever do that to one of my students, right? So the thing that I have my students doing is, right, whenever what we teach in the cryptocurrency investing blueprint, what I have my students doing in the blueprint is to practice buying and selling a small amount, a little bit at a time. The reason why is we need to make that financial transaction. We need to be able to do it and do it frequently and do it constantly, right? So here's the formula, guys, and you guys are welcome to use this, okay? Now, if I need to buy $1,000 of a cryptocurrency, I will split it up into $100 or $200 or $300 chunks And I, every 2 weeks or every week, I would buy that chunk one at a time. I would buy a little chunk here on this paycheck. You know, if I've dedicated $500 or $200 or $100 or $100 to buying crypto, then at that end of that paycheck, I'll take that and go and buy it. What I'm doing there is to practice getting the repetitions in so that I'm fully prepared, so when the market is, it's time for me to sell, I have made enough financial transactions and repetitions to where I can do it easily. Now, some of you guys are listening to this and you say, oh, Ty, but you know, I'm mentally tough. You know, I'm not a dumbass like you. I'm not a stupid ass refugee who came to America, lived in the poor ghetto neighborhoods, dropped out of high school, went to prison for nearly 14 years for being involved in drugs, and come out and then start learning how to make money in my 30s. You know, I've been making money since I was a teenager, so I know how to make these financial transactions, okay? So you might say that, and it's great, okay? It's great. I'm glad that you're not a high school dropout. I'm glad that you have a college degree. I'm glad that that you do not have to go to prison for nearly 14 years for some bullshit drugs like I did, okay? It's all great and handy. But here's the thing, guys. Most of financial transactions that you make in your life, right, is you have time to do that. For example, if you make a $1,000 transaction to buy a computer, buy a car, you spend several weeks, you spend several months doing research on it, you finish doing your research, you're confident that, you know, this is the right price, this is the right time, and then at that time, then you go and do it, right? Now, if you are in the financial markets, it doesn't work that way, okay? The reason why is because in the financial markets, right, prices can move rapidly. It can happen very quickly, very instantly. For example, I bought some Tezos at 75 cents. In less than a month, okay, in just a few weeks, it went up to $1.84, okay? Now, I have to resist the urge in selling that. Most people couldn't do that because they haven't had enough repetitions and practice in, so they couldn't resist the urge to sell. So when it was at from 75 cents to like $1.20, $1.40, $1.50, they sold, okay? They claim they made 100% profit on their coin and they're happy with it, okay? They're texting me, you know, and they're sharing with me, you know, thanking me that, you know, for getting them, you know, for talking about Tezos and sharing my Tezos trade with them, and now they made 100% and they're super happy, okay? But here's the reality, guys. 100% is not worth the effort and the time to get into crypto, okay? You might as well stay in the stock market, and you can make 100%, just like Mark DeMessel. He got into Tesla at $200, around $200, and then now it's at like $410, $405, $410 in just a few months. So that can be done in the stock market, and it's relatively safe, much, much safer than in crypto, okay? So if you're looking for 100% gains, just stay in the stock market. Don't take the risk of coming into the crypto market where you have to have security risk, you know, exchanges can get hacked. You don't have to worry about losing your stocks in the stock market. You don't have to worry about the exchanges getting hacked. You don't have to worry about somebody hacking your account and stealing all your money and all your stocks in the stock market, okay? That alone is that safety, right? That safety is why you don't get a 5x, a 10x, and a 20x return in 6 months or a year or 2 or 3 years like in crypto, okay? So if you want that, you know, multiples gains of 5x, 10x, 20x, 100x, right? We cannot sell right away, okay? And in order to resist that urge to sell right away or to, you know, to buy when the markets run up and taking the wrong action, we have to practice making these financial transactions and these repetitions and get them in, guys. I cannot say this enough. I'm serious, guys. I don't know how to grab you by the throat and shake you awake to tell you that you have to practice making these financial transactions and you have to practice them. Don't worry so much about whether you buy at the absolute low price, okay? It's not that important. What's important is you buy near the low. So it's undisputed right now, if you ask anybody in the markets right now, when everyone agrees that we're near the bottom, we're not at the very bottom, but we are near the bottom, we are in a bear market and we are near the bottom, then it's, to me, it's very safe to buy around this area, okay? Even if it crashes a little bit more, it doesn't matter, because if we are buying every week, every month, then the price will average out to an average low price that's near the bottom of the market. It's not gonna be the absolute bottom, but it's going to be near the bottom, and that's good enough. And when it's time for the markets to go up and we sell, we're not gonna sell at the very top. You know, when I sold some Ethereum at 1100, 1200, 1300, and 1400, that 1400, that was just luck. I'm not going to sit here and look you guys in the face and the eyes and say, oh, you know, I'm a hotshot trader and I sold Ethereum at 1400, right? What about the Ethereum I sold at 1100? What about the Ethereum I sold at 1200? What about the Ethereum I sold at 1300? Okay, so when I'm selling around these prices, right? You might not, you know, it's, I can easily sit here, guys, and lie to you and say that, hey, man, you know, I sold all my ethers at $1,400 and I can screenshot it in my exchange account and show it to you guys. But then that would be lying to you guys. That I'd be just like all the other dumbass traders and all the other fake ass traders online that tell you that they're doing this, but they're not really doing it for a living. Okay. So that's why I'm telling you guys that even when Ethereum was going up, I did not sell it all at the top. I sold it on the way up to the top. And the reason why I was able to do that was because I had done it, so I had practiced doing this so many times and I had the repetitions in. If you don't practice it, guys, when the time comes for you to take action, you will not be able to take action smoothly, cleanly, and efficiently, all right? If you buy right now near the bottom of the market, let's say you buy Bitcoin around $5,000-$7,000, right? And when it goes to the next all-time highs of 20,000, 30,000, 40,000, and you're able to sell when it starts to go up to, let's just say, to 20,000, 25,000, 30,000, 35,000. When you start selling little bits at a time like that, the average price that you get, guys, will be very, very good. It'll be up there near the top. It won't be at the top, but it'll be near the top. And you'll look back and you'll say, hey, man, that guy Ty, you know, that dumbass Vietnamese refugee that grew up in the ghettos of America, you know, that dude had, you know, he's got a good point. He's got a good point. I guess he was right. He's done screwed up so many times already, and he told me, and I did like he said, right? And now here I am. I'm able to confidently take action when it's time for me to take action to buy or to sell. Okay, guys? So the moral of this video, guys, is you got to practice, right? Not too many people know how to make a large financial decision. Not too many people in this world know how to make a large financial transaction, and not too many people have the experience in doing any of this. Okay, so if you want to make life-changing profits in your life, you have to practice making it. And how do we practice it when we don't have a 7, 8, 9-figure portfolio to manage? We practice it with the small amounts of money that we have right now, because the repetitions, guys, is what allows us to get to where we need to be when it's time to make the big money and the life-changing profits. Okay, so thanks for watching this video, guys. I hope that this helps you out to understand why it's so difficult for people to take the right financial action when it's time to in the markets. It's simply because we don't have a lot of experience doing it in our lifetimes, okay? We have lots of experience making a $1, $2, $5, $10 transaction, but when it comes to making $100, $1,000, $10,000, $100,000, $1 million transaction, that is not something that we do very often. And that's the reason why most human beings cannot do that. This should also give you guys, open your minds to asking questions and getting information from people who have not had experience making these large financial transactions frequently, okay? If you are serious about trading and investing and you want to take your game to the next level, right? I highly recommend that you guys go to www.cryptocurrency.market/blueprint and get a copy of our cryptocurrency investing blueprint, because in that cryptocurrency investing blueprint, I share with you guys everything that I did and my team did to allow us to make life-changing profits, right? And be able to retire early, okay? At a very young age, right? I retired in my, you know, mid 40s, okay? And this was not easy, guys. This is not easy for somebody that came from Vietnam as a refugee and grew up in a poor ghetto ass black neighborhood in America and was dumb as shit and dropped out of high school, guys. So the fact is, if I can do it, guys, there's absolutely no reason why you cannot do it, okay? So it's the end of December, the end of 2019, guys, and I wanna wish you and your family a happy holidays, all right? Stay safe if you guys live in the northern parts of the world, okay? Keep warm, okay? I like drinking hot coffee and cocoa and tea during the cold weathers, all right? Keep safe, right? And make sure that you guys get ready for the upcoming New Year's, and let's hope that 2020 will be a great year for all of us, for you and your family, all right? If you guys, instead of, just a reminder too, guys, instead of wasting money on gifts and stupid presents and gifts, all right, for family members and friends and stuff, guys, take that money and go buy you some crypto with it, okay? You might think it's selfish that, hey, you're not getting gifts for your friends and your family, guys, but I'm telling you guys, all right? Take care of yourself first. You. If you're watching this video, you need to take care of yourself first. You need to invest that money into you first, before your family members, before your friends, before your coworkers, before anybody, all right? Instead of spending that $100 on getting gifts for this person, that person, right? Don't worry about them. Get that $100, go get you some crypto, get you some Bitcoin, get you some Ethers, get you some cryptocurrencies right now, because when it becomes 10x, right, you can always pull that $100 back out and then go get the gifts that you want for them. They're not gonna get pissed off at you. They're not gonna get upset with you. And you know what? If they get upset with you because you didn't get them no Christmas presents this year, screw them. They're not your real friends anyway, okay? Just be aware of that, guys. And you don't have to get your family members, all right, gifts every damn Christmas, okay? And get them into a habit that they expect free gifts for doing nothing every damn year, okay? So tell them, and if it's your kids, you tell them, hey, I'm gonna get you a gift. I'm gonna get you some Bitcoins. I'm gonna get you some Ethers. I'm gonna get you some crypto, okay? That's what you should be doing, guys. Don't get them no stupid ass Barbie doll. Don't get them no stupid ass motorcycle that they're gonna run and wear out and forget about it. It's not gonna change their life. That $100 that you get in crypto for your daughter or your son today, that could go up 10x, 20x, 100x. That could pay for their college or get them a car when it's time for them to go to college, guys. That could be life-changing. Getting them all the stupid toys that they have right now, that's not gonna be life-changing. And don't worry about when they cry about it. Trust me, okay? They need to learn that, you know what? When daddy has to make some tough financial decisions, you know, to give them a better future, right? Don't worry about it. I remember when my kids was growing up and they wanted some toys or something, I handed them the kitchen plastic spatula, okay? And a plastic a ladle or a spoon in the kitchen. And my wife looked at me like I was crazy, like, what the hell are you doing? Like, well, why don't you go buy some toys for them? I'm like, no, because that money needs to go into crypto. One of these days, they're gonna be thankful that I took that, you know, money and bought them some crypto instead of buying them some stupid ass, you know, plastic toys that ain't gonna do them nothing. After they play for a week, they're gonna forget about it, okay? And now my wife looks back, right? And now, you know, I have my third child and he was playing around and I handed him a ladle to play with, a plastic spoon to play with, and my wife was looking at me, but she won't dare say nothing because she knows that I had to make those tough choices back then, right? And now I'm retired and I can be with them. I can sit here and shoot these goofy, you know, videos with my kids and shoot these, you know, educational videos for you guys and share with you because I had to make those tough financial decisions, guys. If you make those tough financial decisions this holiday and this upcoming year in 2020, right, or whatever year that you are watching this video in, right, just know that that's gonna pay off, guys. Regardless of what anybody says, you will become wealthy and you will be able to retire early because you are willing to make those tough financial decisions that other people are not willing to make. Just remember that, guys. No matter how many people laugh at you and tell you you're stupid or tell you that you're being selfish or whatever, the fact is, right, that because you are willing to make those tough financial decisions, right, you are going to reap the rewards for it in the future, right? The Bible says that you reap what you sow. If you sow tough financial seeds, decisions today, and plant them and water them and nurture them and put sunshine on it, right, then you will reap the financial benefits of it next year, the year after that, 3 years from now, 5 years from now, 10 years from now, right? Don't give a damn what the trolls and all the haters say. Make those tough decisions today when you're young, when you have the energy and you have the ability to make them and you have the ability to recover from your mistakes, okay? Don't try to practice making tough financial decisions when you're 80 years old and you're about to hit the grave, okay? Make them now while you're still young, okay? Have a great holiday weekend, guys. Follow me on Twitter at HeyTaiZen. Get you a copy of the Cryptocurrency Investing Blueprint at www.cryptocurrency.market/blueprint. Subscribe to our newsletter at www.cryptocurrency.market/newsletter. And I'll see you in the next video in the new year's, guys. Thank you.